Right, we are back yet again for more adventures in Skyrim. Has been a little bit longer than I wanted before making this video. Entirely my fault, well, mostly my fault. Just life and the weather. Unfortunately, and again, talking about things no one cares about, where I live, hold on, catch the butterfly. It's an east-facing window on a fairly busy major road in central London. And you think that would be great. Yeah, it means I'm in the centre of London and it's all going on outside. Unfortunately, the building I'm in is very, very poorly ventilated. And what that means is that heat builds up in my flat all morning and all through the day. And then in the afternoon, it hangs around, rather than vanishing. And what that means is I have to have my windows all open, I have to have fans on everywhere, and having fans on everywhere in this place means they would turn up on the recording. I mean, my computer fan, you might just be able to hear it in the background. If you can, I do apologize. Struggling a little bit because of the warm weather, and I mean, it's not hot outside or anything, far from it, but just because of the way the heat builds up inside of here, it can get a little bit uncomfortable. And that means, you know, with recordings and things, should get our weapon out just in case. Yeah, it just makes it a little bit harder to record. Because I have to wait until it's dark and the temperature's gone down. So, anyway, that aside, we'll get on with this episode. Today we're on our way to High Hrothgar, and we are taking a slightly different route. This is the route I would recommend you to take if you're playing Requiem. There are a couple of different options. You can obviously go around through Dvoltheim, down around here to Iverstead. You can catch a carriage to Riften, and you can follow the lake up again to Iverstead. Or you can take this way. And this way doesn't cost you money. It's actually, I think, probably the quickest of the three routes. And it means you don't have to bypass Valtheim Towers, which is nice. And I'm honestly surprised that Ogre Boss or someone else hasn't put a giant monster up here just to stop people from getting to High Hrothgar too early. Not that you get anything major from High Hrothgar. I mean, you get the second word of Unrelenting Force and the first one of Whirlwind Sprint, which is nice. Nothing amazing, but at the same time, it is a milestone of a sort. You think, you know, you could put something there just to keep people on their toes. Oh, this is apparent. Have I taken this route before? Maybe I have. Maybe I've talked about this before as well, then. Oh, to say the first thing to go is memory. I may well have taken this route before. Oh well. My apologies if that is the case. It does seem to be. All the picked bushes and things around here. Oh well. Right. What else was I going to talk about? Oh yes, I was going to say, Enderal has been released. For those of you who don't know, Enderal is a complete game conversion for Skyrim. It's made by Shore AI is their name. They're a German team, and they've used a Skyrim base game to invent an entirely different game of their own devising. If you ever played Oblivion, and I haven't really played much Oblivion at all, not when it came out either, but there was a they made a similar game conversion for that called Nerim. I think that's how it's pronounced. Anyway, this is the sequel to that, in a way. Although you don't need to have played it, so it's not set in the Elder Scrolls universe or anything like that. It's a completely different setting. And that has come out only in German so far, although the English language version should be released in the following weeks, they've said. They said it shouldn't take too long. Hopefully they're hoping it will take a couple of weeks, but we'll see about that. But yeah, that has now been released. I've considered downloading it, but my German is nicht sehr gut. I did do German at school, but it was a long time ago, and I'm not entirely sure my understanding of German would be sufficient. So, and the German version doesn't have English dubs either. English subs, sorry. The English subs will be released at the same time as the English dubs, so it's just a matter of waiting for that release to happen. Let me get across. Looks like this is the way. But when the English language version is released, I am considering doing some videos for that as well. So performance-wise, I hear it's pretty reasonable. It is more demanding than Skyrim, but not more demanding necessarily than modded Skyrim. I do also have a new laptop, which is comparable with the desktop that I'm recording this on, but it does have a an SSD as well, which might help a little bit. I've noticed playing Skyrim on that, just as I was getting things set up, it was doing pretty well, especially on the recording front, which as you know is the bane of my life. But
on your way up the 7,000 steps again, Klimek?
Not today. I'm just not ready to make the climb to High Rock.
We could help him, but why would we want to? Just gonna go up here to get some food, and then we will make our way up. Got a little bit of food, but I would like a just a little bit more, something to drink. But yes, so when Enderal releases in its English version, I'm thinking of doing a blind playthrough, because they're always fun. I can get people shouting at me for missing obvious things and for doing it wrong and making terrible decisions. It's always good fun. So, yeah.
Pardon me, my lord. Would you care to see my loot? If you fancy a bit of music, let me know.
Like a refill of water.
Of course.
And what do you play?
I play the lute. If you'd like to hear something, it only costs 5 gold.
No.
A pleasant journey, my lord.
We're not going to pay for music. We can go to any tavern in Skyrim and get music for free. I'm not going to pay for it here.
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted.
We'll ask about that later.
Thirsty, food for the hungry.
It Yeah, we want something to eat. Venison chop looks good, and some bread. Maybe not 32 pieces of bread, I think just the one do us.
If you pass through again, stop by for a drink.
I may do that. Oh, we had some bread anyway. Okay. Good. Alright. We'll start the climb to High Hrothgar then. But yeah, so I'm thinking I will do that. Time permitting, of course. Now that it is summer, it would be nice to occasionally enjoy the semi-decent weather we're having. And there's a couple of other things I've got planned for the summer as well, but only a couple, so we shall see. It also depends exactly when it comes out and if other things happen as well. Now that I've graduated again, I'm considering what I want to do next, whether I want to change jobs or pursue a doctorate, things like that. And obviously, you know, those require making applications and so on and so forth. So that might take up some of my time when I'm not working. But as I say, we'll see. But, yeah, so that's happened. Enderal is released. The first sort of the big Skyrim mods we've been sort of expecting or hoping for this summer. So we still don't know what's happening with Awake, the Rise of Menemarco. What happened here? Did these goats kill these wolves? Well, I'm not going to complain. This wolf has two hearts. I don't think that's normal. So does this ice wolf. I will take them, but I'm pretty sure that's not normal. Yeah, we're still not sure what happened with that. They were saying it was a definite June release. Then they said, nope, it's not anymore. We want to polish it some more. We won't say when it's going to be released, though. So hopefully that will be released sometime over the summer. But who knows for sure. And then there's also the Beyond Skyrim mods, which are being worked on with Bruma. Sounds like it's sort of nearing a release date, but it seems to have sounded like that for a while now, so I'm not totally sure when that will happen. Again, we can hope it would be this summer, but hard to say for sure. Oh. Just keep. There we go. Should have soul trapped it. Oh well. Take its fat. It's good for making potions. Oh yes. Unfinished business from the previous episode. Regarding master robes. So I checked and got the information on all the master robes. As it turns out, we had a bit of discussion about this in the comments, there are two master robes for destruction. The second one is in Merun Dagon's shrine up on the mountain. And if you've ever played Requiem, you know how difficult that would be to get. I wouldn't say it was the most dangerous place in Skyrim, but if you are not prepared for it and you've never faced what's inside the shrine before, the infamous invisible entities, you are in for a world of pain. It will hurt. That is pretty much guaranteed. So the other robes. Conjuration. That is in Felglow Keep in the Ritual Summoning Chamber, which is, if anything, worse than the shrine in terms of the things waiting for you inside. It's more invisible entities. I think there's like 8 or 9 of them? I'm not sure. But there's quite a few, and they are quite quite angry. Illusion and Restoration can both be found by doing Vermirna's quest, the one in Dawnguard. So they're actually relatively easy to get, has to be said, compared to the other ones. And then the Alteration Robes are found in the Blue Palace in the Locked Wing. You have to do Shirgorath's quest, then you get to the other side, and they're sort of down right in the corner. And that's where all the Master Robes are. Of course, you could probably kill someone at the college for one of them, but I wouldn't recommend that. Because one, they'd probably kill you. And two, you wouldn't have anyone to train you in magic. But I suppose in theory it's possible if you're completely unscrupulous. Seem to recall a video of someone playing Requiem who got 3 different sets of Guildmaster's armor in a similar fashion. Just went down to the Thieves Guild, killed everyone in there. Thieves Guild Master armor's not bad at all. If you want a good set of evasion armor, that's definitely top tier. Until you get dragon scale anyway. Even then, the enchantments are better. Alright, we're freezing to death, so we have come to the right place, though. Let's just enjoy the view for a moment. Should have looked a little bit more as we were heading up, but can't really see anything anyway with the snowstorm. Right, it's time to speak with the Greybeards, see what they can tell me about being Dragonborn. And we're going to steal some flowers from them. Because they don't need them. I might. Alright, in we go. At least there's plenty of fires in here, that means we can warm up. Let's stand by this fire. This is a bigger one.
A Dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
Okay, let's ask him some questions.
First, let us see if you truly are Dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
That's not.
Do not be afraid. Your shout will not harm us.
Animation for bending down played as I press the button. Now I have to wait for the cooldown.
Shout at us and let us taste of your voice.
Stupid animations. I'll shout at you in a moment. I just need to recover.
Strike us with the power of your voice.
All right. Happy?
Dragonborn, it is you. Welcome to High Hrothgar. I am Master Arngil. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here?
For power, of course. I want to be able to shout at things and make them die. Why else would I come here?
We are here to guide you in that pursuit, just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you.
Okay.
You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say.
All right. Who are you and what is this place?
We are the Greybeards, followers of the Way of the Voice. You stand in High Hrothgar on the slopes of Kinnareth's sacred mountain. Here we commune with the voice of the sky and strive to achieve balance between our inner and outer selves.
Well, as far as our character's concerned, that's lame. We want to be able to set things on fire by shouting at them. That's why we're here.
You have shown that you are dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you? That remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice.
Stand over here, maybe I'll warm up more.
Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Thus, your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Rho, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Rho means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thumb more sharply. Rho!
There we go.
You learn a new word like a monster. You truly do have the gift. But learning a word of power is only the first step. You must unlock its meaning through constant practice in order to use it in a shout. Well, that is how the rest of us learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life force and knowledge directly. As part of your initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Rho.
So why can't I do any of this? Why can't I gift people with my understanding and shout on rocks to put writing on them?
Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear.
I know it wouldn't be a very helpful power, but I'd like to be able to do it. And this shout as well. I want to be able to summon phantoms.
Again. You learn quickly. Once more. Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn.
Yeah, I'm pretty awesome.
Your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
Okay. course, we just warmed up from the snow, so they wanted us to come back out into the snow.
We will now see how you learn a completely new chant. Master Bori will teach you wool, which means whirlwind. Hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thumb. Approach Master Bori and he will gift you his knowledge of wool. Now we will see how quickly you can master a new chant. Master Wolfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn.
Okay, we should probably hotkey this. Yeah. There we go.
Master Bori.
X.
Wolf. Now it's your turn.
Is that a shout?
Next to me, Master Bori.
What they used to open the gate.
Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes.
Beautiful. Just being able to shout at
your quick mastery of a new thume is
treasure chest or something and go.
I've heard the stories of
make it open would be quite handy.
But to see it for myself.
Thank you. What's next?
You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return.
What is it with you people and tombs? Alright, time to play questions. Why are the dragons returning?
No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice, and soon your path will be made clear.
Come on, there's got to be more to it than that.
There is indeed much that we know that you do not. That does not mean that you are ready to understand it. Do not let your easy mastery of the voice tempt you into the arrogance of power. That has been the downfall of many dragonborn before you.
Well, I think it's a bit late for that. I think we've already been tempted into the arrogance of power. We are a destruction mage, after all, I mean. Okay, why the shouts in the dragon language?
Dragons have always been able to shout. Language is intrinsic to their very being. There is no difference in the dragon tongue between debating and fighting. Shouting comes as naturally to a dragon as breathing or speaking. In mythic times, when mortal kind was in great need, the goddess Kinnereth granted us the ability to speak as dragons do. For most people, long years of training are required to learn even the simplest shout. But for you, the dragon speech is in your blood, and you learn it almost without effort.
Okay, who was Jürgen Windcaller?
He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, a master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition, and the way of the voice was born.
Don't know about that. Maybe you lost at Red Mountain because you're all Nords. And Nords aren't exactly known for being eloquent. I mean, if the Dunmer had the knowledge of the Thune behind them, they probably would have conquered the world. That's why we're better than you. Yeah. No, we're going to use our powers to do whatever the heck we want, and you can't stop me. Alright, what's the way of the voice?
The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance.
Yep, I don't follow your philosophy, so why are you helping me?
The Dragonborn is an exception to all the rules. The dragon blood itself is a gift of the gods. If we accept one gift, how can we deny the other? As Dragonborn, you have received the ability to shout directly from Akatosh. We therefore seek to guide you on the proper use of your gift, which transcends the restrictions which bind other mortals.
Okay. Let's see. I think that's enough questions for now.
Sky, got you.
It's getting late in the day here, so we should probably make our way back down to Iverstead before it gets dark. Just warm up for a minute by the fire. Okay. Probably better off to warm ourselves by the fire in here anyway. But yeah, we'll make our way back down. I will say, I am in no hurry to do Ustengrav. It's not difficult or anything. I mean, if you've done Bleak Falls Barrow, Ustengrav is not an issue. But it's what follows after that that I'm in no hurry to do. Once you do that, then it's a quick follow-on to the Blade in the Dark quest. And then once that's done, dragons start randomly attacking everywhere. At the moment, all the dragons are at their nesting sites, their nesting grounds. So we don't have to worry about them unless we actually go directly to a word wall or a top of a mountain or something, which is nice. We don't want to be fighting dragons right away. And we did all right with Irelef and the White Run Guard backing us up, but fighting dragons on our own, with no preparation, possibly out in the wilderness where there's very little cover, it's not something I want to be doing right away. Once we've got a little bit more destruction and conjuration behind us, yes, absolutely. Then it'll be awesome because, you know, we can summon a Storm Atronach and then we can hit them with some fairly powerful destruction spells and it will all be good. But at the moment, not so much. So I'm not sure what we will do. It's still probably a little early to do Felglow Keep. I mean, we could probably power our way through it, but wouldn't be easy, it wouldn't be fun. It'd be kind of like that vampire, only for an entire fortress. It would be quite frustrating. Oh, this way. It's about to go down that way, which would be a very bad idea. I should also make a fire somewhere at some point. I keep seeing this notification that I've got these endurance perks, which I haven't actually refunded yet. Surprised at the relative lack of dangerous wildlife we had on the way up. We had the frost troll, but that aside, there wasn't really anything. I was expecting maybe a bear, a couple of ice wraiths, and the troll. Remember the very first time I did this, when I was doing my first Skyrim playthrough ever, I had a dragon attack me on the way up. That wasn't fun. It was a blood dragon. I'd only just turned level 15 or something, I think, in standard Skyrim, so nothing, really. I had a friggin' dragon attack me. Just here, actually. Just in this area here. It would be fair to say I was not expecting that. I did enjoy my first Skyrim playthrough. You know how it is, it's brand new and fresh, and you're just exploring. Did a lot of exploring in Falkreath and the Rift. They were nice areas to wander around, and especially in the sort of more mountainous parts of Falkreath, there's a lot of nice hidden things around there. Especially when you end up going towards the area where Arkwind Point is. Although I think, was Arkwind Point added with Dawnguard, or I'm not sure. I do remember that I stopped playing for a while because Mass Effect 3 came out a few months later and I got into that. I was having fun with that for a while, and then Dawnguard came out. I was like, oh, I should probably play some more Skyrim so I can get to a point where I can play Dawnguard. Our character will be joining the Dawnguard at some point. He's killed a vampire and he's got a taste for it. Plus, even though our guy is not the most devout person in the world, he does follow the three good Daedra. And Boethia hates vampires. A little bit of lore there for you. Boethia hates vampires because they're a creation of Molagbal, and Boethia hates Molagbal. And in Morrowind, the temple actually has quite a few. I know it's not the Tribunal Temple, it's the it is the Tribunal Temple, it's not the Reclamations Temple, but they're very similar in some ways, I think it's fair to say. Yeah, the anticipations are basically ersatz, Daedric princes. And yeah, they send you on quite a few vampire hunting quests, as I recall. In my own playthrough, my own sort of sporadic playthrough of Morrowind I'm doing at the moment with Open Morrowind with the new engine. I have not got that far in any of the quest lines yet that they've asked me to kill a vampire, thankfully. Although, I'm chugging along quite nicely in the Morag Tong quest line. It turns out if you have a high personality score and a high speechcraft score, you can pretty much goad anyone into attacking you. That means you can kill them all nice and legal. Right, we may be having some unwanted company here in a moment. Just keeping an eye out. Well, maybe not. Don't see them. Alright, let's go inside and warm up.
When I passed by, Journey, I met a college wizard who was trying to brew a more potent ale. Ha! If that's what they teach at the college, I should have become a mage.
Going by some of the people at the College of Winterhold, they need to stop drinking.
Welcome to the Villamere Inn.
Okay, let's warm up.
Just let me know.
I'm waiting for the followers of Nirak to show up.
Another batch of logs completely ruined. I swear these bears have it out for me.
I hardly think the bears are clever enough to hold a grudge against you, Miss Temba.
When I want your opinion, I'll ask for it. Otherwise, mind your business.
Jeez. No wonder the bears hate her, if that's her attitude. Alright then, I think we will save it here. Then we'll rest the night, see if our friends turn up.
I think you should continue with your performances.
What's the point? I'm not very good and it's only for the same few people every night.
I think you played beautifully. It would be a shame if you stopped.
All right, Wilhelm. I suppose it's the least I can do for you.
Wilhelm.
If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side.
Oh,
of
yes.
Town. It's haunted.
Tell me about the barrow.
There ain't much more to tell. They're haunted, and you should stay away. Look, I've seen one of the spirits with my very own eyes. When it glared at me, I swear it burned right through my soul.
Mm-hmm. Do the spirits ever, you know, come into town, attack people, speak in ancient Nordish?
Fortunately, they seem to be sticking to the barrow. I think they're guarding it. Certainly isn't helping my business any. Who'd want to rent a room anywhere near a haunted barrow?
Well, I could take care of it for you. I'm quite good at killing undead.
If you think there's anything you can do, be my guest.
Quite good at killing most things, actually. Has anyone actually explored the barrow?
About a year or two ago, some fella named Windelius came through. Said he was some kind of a treasure hunter. I warned him not to go in there, just like I warned you. The very next night, we heard screams from the barrow, and that was it. We never saw him again.
Is there any other work while I'm here?
Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
Trevor's watch.
If you're headed up to the monastery, watch your step. It's a long way down.
Yeah, I noticed that. Oh, I want to rent a room.
We don't get many visitors through here. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
Okay. I think we'll go have a quick look at this barrow before we settle into our room
Let
for the
me
night.
Know if there's anything else you need.
What's that dagger you've got? That's a Thalmor dagger. What are you doing with a Thalmor dagger? Okay. Save again just in case our friends are indeed outside. And then we're going to go have a look at this barrow quickly. If there's anything worth looking into regarding it, we will do that tomorrow after we get a good night's sleep. Yep, this is definitely a barrow. Lots of dead bodies. Oh yes, I was going to say, regarding the black soul gem we picked up in the previous episode, although we're Our character is, of course, opposed to necromancy as a way of life. I don't think he'd be opposed to using black soul gems. I mean, the way I'm sure he'd see it is anyone stupid enough to attack him is probably not worth worrying about what happens to their soul. It's close to necromancy, but it's not quite the same thing. I don't know. That is a quandary. I mean, we're probably going to have plenty enough souls anyway, given our skill set. But something to think about.
Leave this place. Leave this place. Leave. Leave.
Make me.
Leave.
We'll take that. Okay, so it's one of these delightful Nordic traps where, as you can see, they've got the traps there and there. And one of these levers opens the door, but we don't know which one, so that's that didn't quite work as planned. There we go. And that was complete guessing, by the way. I had no idea which ones they were. It's been a while since I've done Shroud Hearth Barrow. I tend to do it after doing after doing High Hrothgar. That looked like it would be painful. Alright, let's get this open. There's a new mod for lockpicking in Requiem. Let me just make a save here. Which I don't know if I'm going to use it for this playthrough. But I may use it, I'm going to give it a try. And use it for, if I like it, to use it for future playthroughs. Because it changes the lockpicking and how it works. I can't remember the exact details. But it's more like you can pick, you can pick something like a level above the perk you have. Ooh. Take those. Which obviously is quite nice. Let's run. And it also changes the material component for using the lockpick spell. So yeah, I think you still need Quicksilver. But it doesn't consume it on use, which is something that always annoyed me about the spell for arcane lockpicking.
I sense a presence.
No, you don't.
More. No one hides. You
had a bow? Oh, so he did. I do like that. Potion of the Phantom. You weren't very helpful. Didn't even distract him, although I suppose he did go down quite quickly. Huh. Iron Gauntlet, Skull, Ale, no thank you. Another potion. And his journal. Okay, he needs to find a claw. Things that's hidden here isn't. He tends to be a ghost to give himself more time. He goes mad from pretending to be a ghost, and it all goes horribly wrong from there. Alright, let's give Windelius the good news. This place was only haunted by a complete idiot. Yeah, so obviously I want to test the mod before I use it. I just remembered we actually leveled up. But if it does work and I do end up doing another Requiem playthrough, as I've mentioned I might when I'm done with this one, or when I get bored, whichever, you know, comes first. Just keeping an eye out for the cultists. Okay. Then, I'll give that a try, and if I like it, I'll include it. So I do think that's one element of Requiem that could be improved, the whole lock-picking approach. I didn't find it very very appealing to me. Right. I think we're going to put point in health. And we have two perks. What do we need for that? We need 50. I was hoping it was going to be 40, but 50 does sound more like it. Okay, I'm thinking a point in evasion, so we can work our way towards agile spellcasting. It's tempting. What have we got here? Being able to use our Thume more often would be nice, but our Thume is not going to be our primary weapon. So let's just see. Sword specialization? Or alchemy? We're going to do sword specialization. Do alchemy at any time. Alchemy is easy to level once you have access to expensive ingredients anyway. Yes. This will give us an incentive to use our sword a little bit more as well. Right. I think we're going to call it quits for this episode now. Thank you very much for watching, as always, and I will see you next episode. I think